What's up everybody, it's Eli here from Treefall Studios, and today I have a brand new game development tips and talks video. Today we're going to be taking a look at my income as an indie game developer, and we're going to be breaking down all the sources of income and how much they are. Just a huge disclaimer before we get started, before you guys dislike and unsub from this channel, I cannot give you exact dollar figures or exact sales numbers for certain platforms. So we will be discussing exact dollar figures for you and give you information on that for all my alternate sources of income outside of game sales. I will be even mentioning Steam sales because I'm allowed to talk about those. However, I will be showing you charts and comparisons to kind of give you an idea how game sales compared to my alternate sources of income, but you will not see an exact dollar figure for those. This is an overall advice video to give you an insight into how to diversify your income, where you should be getting income from as a game developer, about how much that income is you can expect to get based on your skill level, and I'll be going over all of my advice on how to stay in business and how to become an indie game developer at the end of this video. Real quick, before we get started, if you're new to the channel, my name's Eli and I run an indie game development studio called Treefall Studios. On this channel, I make videos about game development, tips and talk, as well as game development tutorials to take beginners who want to get into game development, who have no experience, and tell them how I got started and the best ways for them to get started in game development and how to avoid the mistakes that I have made. Also, I document my game development journey on this channel, showing off devlogs of my games. So if any of that sounds interesting to you, be sure to hit that subscribe button. It really helps out the channel. And if you're ready to get started and learn about my sources of income, drop us a like and let's get started. All right, income source number one is merchandise. We have an account on a site called TeePublic, and TeePublic is a site where you can upload your designs and have them fulfill the orders, print them on shirts, and ship the orders to your customers for you. We chose a site like this in order to have no kind of overhead. Buying a bunch of shirts that we can't sell would be a huge waste in business for us. So we are starting off explaining this source of income to you. And just so you know, this is the smallest source of income that I have, that we have as a game development team. So far, our lifetime sales of shirts have been $20.50. I'm also going to be breaking down in charts showing you overall what my entire income is from 2014 to now in comparison from all of these sources, as well as the 2021 income so far for all of these sources, just to go ahead and let you know that, because we have not sold any merchandise in 2021. We have sold a few shirts in the past, but you only get a couple dollars per shirt, even though, you know, the shirts sell for like 20 something dollars on the website. You only get to take a couple dollars from that. And that number also is a little bit of a lie in general, because I've purchased all of the shirts for myself, shirts for my family, for my girlfriend. Inside of that $20.50 is our purchase as well. But I can confirm that we have sold shirts to random people, so I just wanted to throw this in there as the very first stepping stone, because this idea is completely free if you're trying to start up a company. It builds some fan rapport with you. I mean, they can wear merchandise out, if they're willing to wear your logo or wear your characters out on their shirts, that's free marketing for you as well. And it's just a good idea. It doesn't take long to set it up. If you've already got the art ready, you can make a little money from this as well. I would like to grow this year as I grow my fan base and hopefully sell some more shirts, but we don't really advertise it a whole lot. I don't really push it too much, but hopefully as our fan base grows, we can also grow this source of income. All right, so let's move on from that and talk about income source number two. This is payments from Valve. So Valve Corporation runs a platform called Steam. If you're watching this channel, I'm sure you know exactly what that is. Steam is the largest PC distributor platform where you can buy PC games on the computer. It's a pretty awesome platform. I also have a video, one of my most popular videos, called how much my indie game made on 1 week on Steam. And at that point, I'd only made $127 on my game. There's some dislikes on that video, even though a lot of people understood what I was trying to say in the video, and it's one of my most popular videos. Some people misunderstood and that I was dissing on Steam because it's very difficult to make money in 2021 as a small indie developer who's just learning. Maybe if your games are a little unpolished, it's going to be really difficult for you to make money on Steam. So to go ahead and share my overall number at this point, that was about a year ago, and that was $127. So far now, about a year in, my entire income from Steam is $342.07, I believe. So not too bad. It's growing up there a little bit. We've gotten a couple payments from there. I have two games currently on Steam, Maze, which is also available on Nintendo Wii U and PlayStation 4, and then also The Perplexing Orb 2, which is available on PlayStation 4 and Steam. Both of the games that are currently available on Steam have sold an unbelievably higher number on consoles versus Steam. I talked about how the consoles in general, with the same level of marketing, the same exact game, the same pricing structure, sold a lot better to console players than they did PC players. And I think a lot of PC people were offended by that and kind of, you know, trashing on my games and stuff like that. But the point wasn't to say that I should have sold more, it was just a comparison video. And indie games are harder to sell successfully unless you have an unbelievably standout title on Steam. That's just because there's just so many games coming out on Steam every single day. It's really hard to stand out unless you're one of those once in a drop in a bucket gems that are just really hard to come by. Usually the really, really talented indie developers can stand out and make a lot of money on Steam. But if you're a beginner who's trying to get started, just want to experience what it's like to become a game developer, see if you can make any money at it trying to follow your dream, it is going to be pretty difficult in order to make money on Steam. But this is not something I would say to give up. This is definitely an area that can help boost your income, if it's not the main source of your income. And I definitely plan to try to grow this and do new marketing techniques and try to grow my PC audience in 2021. Okay, so now we're going to get into the more substantial sources of income. Places where if you are an indie game developer and you're starting out and you have a game concept, maybe the game's not even done, and you're trying to think, how am I going to make an income? How am I going to work on this game full time, start up a company, and actually survive? This is the first stepping stone that I would suggest that you should look into. And that for us is Patreon. This is my highest source of alternate income, and we are really appreciative to all of the patrons that we have that support Treefall Studios on Patreon.com. Over the last couple years, we've brought in more than $3,210 from our Patreon page. This has been over a couple of years. We've only had fluctuating between maybe 3 to 8 patrons at a time in any given month. We've had some join, some drop off, some have stayed with us since the beginning. Some people have given money in earlier years, dropped off, and then rejoined. It all just fluctuates over and over. So I would say, as a game developer, this is an income source that you should look into having and running alongside your game development. So let me explain a little bit about what Patreon is. It is a website that allows you to have monthly subscription tiers for fans who wish to support you. To be honest, you do provide them rewards and you provide a service to those fans, but this is a way for your fans who really care about your company and who want to see you succeed to help support you financially. For example, on our Patreon page, we have 3 tiers, $1, $3, and $5, I believe. I believe that we're going to be changing that to 1, 5, and 10 coming up pretty soon. But some of the rewards that we offer for our fans who support us on Patreon is access to private posts only. They get to see early posts once a month. And it used to be a little bit more frequent, but now to do more substantial posts, we're doing once a month. You get an early access look at games. You get to vote on games that we're currently working on, and they get to see stuff that other people don't get to see. Another big benefit that we give our patrons for supporting us on Patreon is shouting them out in YouTube videos. So without further ado, instead of reaching the end of the video, we're gonna go ahead and shout out our 3 patrons for this month, which is Carmen Red, LV, and Overhyped Gamer. Thanks so much for supporting us on Patreon.com. On top of that, you also get other features like sometimes for the largest tiers, you can get early playtest demos of our games and you get your name in the credits of the games. So you get to be a part of the game development experience. It doesn't cost us money in order to give out rewards. Every once in a while, we're going to ship out merchandise and posters and things like that to our patrons, but we do not do that every month. So we're offering mostly digital rewards in order for return for monetary gain. So this is very easy to set up if you're just trying to get into indie game development. You can offer some of the same rewards that we're offering. There's plenty of ideas out there, but I think overall that this source of income is definitely something that you should have in your arsenal if you want to stay in business as a small-time indie game developer. And now, of course, we're going to be moving into your bread and butter as an indie game developer. And of course, this is going to be game sales. The most important thing that you're going to be making money from is your game sales. Until you have a YouTube channel that explodes and you're making buku bucks from advertising and affiliate links, this is going to be the number one income source for you as you're getting started as a game developer. So we're going to be talking about my sales from Nintendo. This is actually our highest source of income overall for all time, but it's a little deceiving. We are currently going to be making more money from PlayStation, but I'm putting this here before we talk about PlayStation sales, just because currently our Nintendo sales are much smaller. Also, Nintendo sales span from years 2014 all the way till now, so we've been selling games on Nintendo's platforms for much longer than we've been selling games on PlayStation's platforms. And when you see the charts compared, we're kind of moving in the strongest position with our PlayStation sales and our PlayStation fans. But that's not to say that our Nintendo sales weren't amazing. We would not be in business still to this day if it wasn't for our Nintendo fans and our sales on Nintendo platforms. So to talk a little bit about it, we've released a bunch of games. So these games are older games. Some of the very first games that I ever created were on the Wii U. You know, they're not the greatest, not the highest polish, but there's a lot of games on that system that do have a lot of good ideas in them and are still fun to play to me and some of our fans. So we're really glad to all the fans that have enjoyed those games over the years and purchased them and picked them up so we could still be learning and growing and making better games for you today. Of course, I can't mention any individual sales. I will say that The Letter is our highest selling game of all time, and that's the one that we got crapped on the most for. It was the first game that I had ever created, and all sorts of large mainstream media outlets talked about how it was one of the worst games ever created, and that basically kickstarted my career with the worst game ever. So I guess you can't get worse than that, and we're only moving forward and being positive as we learn and get better. So if you take a look at the chart on the screen, Nintendo is the second to last on this chart. As you can see, the income from our game sales just dwarfs all of the other alternate sources of income, but that is not a complete picture. Those alternate sources of income are incredibly important for us staying in business in 2021, because in 2021, the chart that you've got up on the screen, you can see the Nintendo sales are just about in line with all of the rest of our current income sources. So they are still important. We still rely on our income coming from our old Wii U games, and we still rely on all those smaller alternate income sources that we mentioned earlier in this video. As you notice, we have not mentioned any sales for the Nintendo Switch. All of those sales were on the Nintendo Wii U. Nintendo, for some reason, has a very strict policy on who is approved as a publisher for their system. It is very interesting. We've been trying to get approved, and we're not going to give up, but currently we are not an approved publisher for Nintendo Switch. So as an indie game developer watching this video, if you're starting from scratch, you don't even have your game created yet, this is a good, important piece of information that you should take note of, that you're probably not going to get your game on Nintendo Switch unless you get somebody else to publish it. So now we're going to talk about PlayStation, which is our most important current source of income. We'll throw the charts up on the screen again. As you can see, it's already catching up to our Nintendo income, and PlayStation, we haven't been on it nearly as long. And we are just now growing our PlayStation fan base for the first time substantially since 2018. Currently, we have games releasing on PlayStation 4, and they're backwards compatible on PlayStation 5, but we do not have our PlayStation 5 editions out just yet. As a brand new developer, this is my number one recommendation that I would tell you to go for. If you're going to do any platforms as a game developer starting out, I would pick the PlayStation. Overall, I think they have the easiest platform to work with. I think they have the best way to get started for people who are new. I would recommend doing everything you needed to do in order to get started with PlayStation and start putting your games on both PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5. Okay, now that you've taken a look at my five sources of income, seen some dollar figures, seen some comparison charts, I'm going to be going over the new sources of income that I would like to grow and or add this year to our repertoire of game development sources of income. And then after that, I'll be going over advice on overall what I think that you guys should be doing when you're starting out your game development studio. So the next piece of income that I would like to add in order to help us stay stable overall as a game development team is YouTube. I'm currently talking to you through a YouTube video and we are extremely close to becoming monetized. So if you've watched this far into this video and you've learned anything so far in this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you're just starting out in game development, I would definitely say running a YouTube channel can be a viable source of income for you in the future, as well as a good way to grow your audience and get people involved in the development of your games and enjoying the games that you're making. So to wrap this up, I want to give you guys just a little bit of an overview about what kind of income you can expect and what my advice to you as a game developer is if you're just getting started. So I think I've been doing this since 2014. And really, it's hard to judge my income sources versus how it will be for you because I've been developing over a long period of time. I've been working some part-time, mostly part-time in the beginning, while working other jobs. So it could have been more if I was working more full-time. And then I went to college and then I hardly worked and released any games in the very beginning. Right when we released Pitterpot, there was a big break before that and a big break after that while I was finishing up my degree in school. So there's a little bit of the lapse of income that way. And now is the first time that I've actually been working full time for the past year or so, even though on top of my full time hours for this game development studio, I did work for a few months with heavy part time hours, basically almost doing two jobs for a couple of months. So just keeping that in mind, when you're starting out a brand new studio, you might have to work other jobs and you might have to balance out what kind of income you're going to be getting from those jobs versus the hours and how many hours it's going to take you to complete the games and get those out for yourself. Let's say that if you're just getting started, you're looking at probably a minimum wage income to lower middle class income at best. If you're just starting out and you have no experience, you gotta expect to not make a lot of money, and that is my warning to you if you're watching this video on how to try to create a game development studio and how to get enough income to stay full-time. So my number one piece of advice on if you want to stay full-time and you want to follow this dream no matter what it takes, it's gonna take a lot of time, a lot of sacrifice, and a lot of hours to make games. You're gonna be needing to release on all these platforms that I mentioned. Try to get in with Nintendo. Focus on PlayStation, really build your PC audience, try to do other alternate sources of income like growing a Patreon page, selling merchandise, starting a YouTube channel, eventually getting ad revenue, growing your audience through YouTube. All of that, it's going to take all of that in order just to sustain a regular income. But in my opinion, it is completely worth it. It is a fun, rewarding job, and when people play the games and really enjoy them and you give them an experience that they really like and you put a smile on people's faces, that to me is why I do it. I love to play games. I love the experiences of certain games that I play, and I want to do the best that I can do to provide unique experiences to bring joy to other people. So if that sounds like fun to you and you don't mind sacrificing, being a little frugal and trying to work really hard to get your company off the ground, then my advice is just go for it. With that being said, guys, I hope you really enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something, whether you're someone who's trying to start an indie game studio and see what kind of sources of income, what they look like, and where you should be getting income, or if you just watch this video because you're interested in checking out what other people make in terms of money. please drop a like. It really helps out the channel. If you made it this far, just go ahead and smash that like button 1,000 times, and I'll see you in the next one.